I'm Just so we're clear. Attach this file, you know. Oh, it's still doing this thing. Shit.
You were laying on the carpet like you're sitting in a coffin. You said that you believe what you're saying, yeah. Right now, but not that often. Are you dead? Are you sleeping? Coffee, are you here right now? Or are there problem fossils under your
Shit.
Thank you.
I'm just going to trust George with the master. I'm just going to trust him. Like, trust, not T-Rust. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to trust him. Yeah, I know you're going to find out from there. Yo, George, you want to hit? You want to hit on this shit? Like, you want another non-boss DJ? You let me know, because this shit so far is already sounding like, you know, pretty big. But let me know if you want another non-boss DJ so I can fucking... That was me. You know what it was about non-boss DJ? Like, I just didn't like the fucking, like, when the drums came, I was like, it could have been a lot stronger, or, like, I could have felt it a little bit different. I don't know. Like, I don't know if you probably... I don't know if you took offense to that. Please don't take offense. Like, what I wanted was, like, I wanted it to break shit. I felt like that beat mended things. You know what I mean? Like, I wanted non-boss DJ to kind of, like, break auto-tune and shit. That's all, like, but I really, really, really do love the song. Like, please don't think I'm trying to play the song. I definitely feel like you're going to kill me, because the only suggestion I had was for the beat to, like, break shit. That's it, but... Much love, like you're a genius, you are a genius, and I just want you to be appreciative of the work I put in. I don't know, I feel wrong, I feel something wrong, something is terribly wrong. Anyway, because something is all right. Yeah, it was the plug-in I put in the beat. So yeah, I'm about to send this one on. Like, honest feedback is one thing. It's another thing, like, when, like, I've gotten so used to, like, musicians coming in on songs and just doing shit just so they can claim the song for themselves. So, like, I, as much love as I have for you, like, you have to understand, like, Sydney. Whenever Sydney would, like, whenever somebody would get too close to Sydney's bowl, she'll just, like, bite their head off. And the problem was, like, I felt like what you were doing, although it was out of, like, brotherly love, it was too reminiscent of what happens in the music business. Because, like, I have laid bass lines down for, like almost every monster record that's hit the surface, like songs that like I might not have done but so much, but like they were big records, and they like the producer would keep a big name, and like I'm not that big of a super producer, if you will, or whatever, like, but it was just like crazy shit. So I'm looking at the situation like, yo, like, y'all niggas, like, I'm not even mad that I'm not getting paid. It's just, don't sit in front of people and say, like, this song is, like, you know, I put in so much work. Like, nigga, like, nothing was going on until I picked up the instrument. Like, zero was going on. So, like, I feel where you're coming. Like, I feel what you go through all the time. Like, You know what I'm saying? Like, such a thing is the reason why I made this shit. Like, I have a disco album I'm working on, so I made this beat. You know what I'm saying? Like, I might not necessarily, like, I might not let the fat lady sing, if you will, but, like, I'll fucking go in the studio and just, like, pick up an instrument, and the whole beat would be made from there, and I'm looking at niggas like, what? Like, that's it? And I'm mad as shit, because, like, I didn't fucking sat there and like did nothing and the song is done and people are looking at me like, wow, you're like the savior of music, like the fuck, I didn't even do nothing yet. So when people are sitting there like, wow, like you're great, like talking to other producers and shit, give me a bottle, I'll drop a couple of names and shit. I don't have Rebel Girls. What album was that on? Let me know. But, I got Rogues, but don't have Rebel Girls. Don't have Rebel Girls. Yeah, so, I'll sit back and, like, try to piece together, like, some pretty cool songs. And then these songs are turning, like, a whole bunch of other instruments and, like, for you, when I heard Nonball's DJ, I was like, I'm glad we're collaborating, but like, in the 12% doubt, I can legitimately say, like, I might be getting played, and like, since that could lead to me getting punched in the head, like, I'd rather just like, not think it, and just like, try to come up with ways to be such a good producer where you won't feel the need to have to do that. You know what I mean? Like, you could just, like, love what you're hearing and feeling. You know what I'm saying? But, like, shit, the fact that you're even working with me on this album means a lot more to me. But, whatever. See? All right, Rebel Girl, let me see the link. All right, I have to get two more Incubus albums. I don't have, the Inertia song or album, and I don't have If Not Now What, which would explain a lot. But I stopped listening to Incubus because, like, I started noticing a few similarities in my style, and it's like, look, if y'all don't know what an Incubus is a demon that has sex with you in your sleep. So the fact I listen to Incubus justifies from 2009 until I just said that. But, like, there's no, like, women are getting the Incubus feeling from other artists, and those other artists don't know where they're getting it from. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't know what they're doing with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, shit, like, girl, give you some good pussy. Like, if you don't know what to do with it, you don't know if it's good or not. So I'm basically dealing with like a bunch of girls who been getting screwed. Like, the dude knows what they're doing, but unfortunately they don't. So I'm you already know I'm like a little too protective of you. Like, you know, like my chubby son. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not sunning you. I'm just saying, like, my chubby son. look at my son, look at my son. You know, and parent teacher, and I like shoot a teacher in the head or some dumb shit, right? But he didn't do anything. So, shit like that. This is gonna be mad easy. Let's see. Get me back. I got it. As you can hear.
I'm Thank you.
Yo, George, I'm gonna make this a monster. Damn. I'm writing the hook of this shit already. Alright, let's see. How many drinks I need? I did a lot of work today. I still want to play a couple beats. Let's see. Rebel Girl in here. Let's see. Alright, let's move the phone first. It's 5 beats so far. He said, send him, like, let's do, like, 5 EPs or so. Like, yeah, like, I'm, like, I just take my time. Well, I always take my time with every beat, but, like, I could go crazy. Like, I could, like, just leave me with my drives and my laptop, and I'll bring Gadget out, and I could do this shit anywhere, but, like, fucking, it's crazy. This is already a pretty cool problem. Every time I work with an artist, like, I always have the fear of, I call it M-ing it. Like, because, like, I already have, like, a name or whatever, and, like, my musical reputation speaks for it, so people are like, oh, Charles is gonna kill this shit, so you'll only listen to it because of the fact that I'm on it. And I don't like that. And that's the reason why, like, in the last 4 to 6 months, I've been keeping my mouth shut about Sega. And every time I do a song or I make a beat with somebody else on it, I make sure they get enough spotlight. The very partnership me and Shalik have, like, I make sure he gets enough ample spotlight so you, the listener, have an opportunity to decide whether or not you like this music or you like their art or whatever it is they do. I step back and let them do their thing after I introduce it. Now, this, it's a double-edged sword because somebody could very easily say, I'm using Charles Hamilton to get on, or they'll be my friend for a second. Like, honestly, in the case of Jilly, like, be my friend for a second, do a song, go somewhere else, and that's the end of it. Or, like Piff and those guys, like, oh, like, you're not that hot, you gotta make some hood records to get on. Like, all right, well, just make sure these songs don't get anywhere, because Piff and his people got me the beat to Intentions, and Lil B ended up on it. I was like, oh, I thought I wasn't hot, I thought nobody cared about my shit. Like, the fuck out of here. Like, you and Amen, go capitalize off of this yourself. Like, I'm not hot. Like, I am not Drake hot. You know what I'm saying? I'm not Wayne hot. I'm not Nicki hot. If you know me, you listen to my shit. It's that simple.
So, but if you know me and you know how I am about music, you know I get down. So because I get down, like, I'm going extra hard because George Massa, his reputation speaks volumes musically. And that's, like, Llama Beats alone is, like capitalizes on the Miami scene. Like, nobody in Miami is listening to Miami Sound Machine music, despite the fact. And, like, he completely brought, like, Fly Low's, like, Grandma's Basement sound to Miami. And that's, like, what I love hearing him on these kinds of beats. You know what I mean? He's like an electro Mad Lib whenever he wants to be. And he can be really soulful whenever he wants to be. And I love that. And, like, I'm not trying to, like, I almost don't want to rap on this album because I don't want people, I don't want, like, some Mojo Jojo Etchison fucking kid to go on and download this. Like, I only downloaded it to listen to Charles. Like, that it happened with Corp, too, and, like, Corpy. And, like, even though I have a couple of objections because of some things he didn't say, like, regardless, like, I was showing a sense of loyalty and camaraderie to not just the black community, not just to FDA, but to somebody who, like, despite how I might have felt about some of his sideways-ass comments, was, like, listening to me play the guitar. Like, I was learning the guitar, and he was, like, jamming with me. So, like, oh, shit, that's like, really cool. Somebody stepping up and is being my friend. So, like, not only is Llama being a friend, like, I'm not trying to, like, oh, look, it's a white boy rapping. Like, I'm going to get on this shit and kill this shit. Like, no, fuck out of here. Like, this isn't ASAP and Space Ghost Perp. You know what I'm saying? Like, there apparently seems to be a pyramidical bond within Sega to which I give my allegiance and my attention to. And he stands out in it. And because of his standing out, I want him to stand out. You know what I mean? Like, I want, like, all right. I,